McGuire, and we're talking about the end of the age. All of the prophecies of the ancient Hebrew prophets and the New Testament prophets coming true in our lifetime. Now, think of how sad this is. You have political leaders, political ideologies like communism, where they insist that there is no God. And in their own writing, they say anything, including killing 100 million people, is justified as long as it produces the ideal communist state. Now, in the ideal communist state, the individual doesn't count. You don't count. It's the group. It's the collective. You lose all your freedoms, and you end up living in a prison nation, a police state. And every example of a communist state that's arisen has been a horrible tragedy where millions have died, tortured, and were suffering. That is mankind's attempt to create the kingdom of God on planet Earth. Yet, let's expose the lie, for example, of communism. And I talk about this in detail in my book, The Day the Dollar Died. The two writers who wrote the Communist Manifesto, Karl Marx, was originally a Christian. And the communists like to teach that he just became an existentialist and a materialist, and he was had nothing to do with spirituality, and he helped create Marx's theory, Karl Marx. That is not true. Karl Marx was an active member of a satanic church. He regularly worshipped in a satanic church. This is a matter of historical record. You can read his poetry, which attests to that fact. He was a Satanist. He wasn't neutral when it came to religion, as the communists would teach. And the co-author of the Communist Manifesto, Engels, he was a Christian. But he felt so guilty and so tortured about what he did in writing the Communist Manifesto, because he saw how it killed hundreds of millions of people and how spiritually evil this document was, that Engels fell to his knees and repented before God, asking God for forgiveness for writing the Communist Manifesto. This is the co-author of the Communist Manifesto, falling to his knees, asking God for forgiveness for creating this evil document. And you can read Engels' own writings. They're available. You can read them in my book, The Day the Dollar Died, where Engels talks about his repentance to God, and then he talks in great biblical detail about 1 Thessalonians and 2 Thessalonians and the Antichrist and the return of Jesus Christ and the resurrection from the dead. So it's quite obvious that Engels had a conversion away from Marxism, and he became a Christian who received Christ by faith. Now, let's talk about atheists. We have a lot of scientists and comedians and television personalities and authors who strut around with great bravado and brag that they're atheists and mock and ridicule Christianity. I personally find it rather pathetic and humorous, and I'll tell you why I find it humorous. Because if we were talking about the Easter Bunny or the Tooth Fairy, nobody